Many of you would have seen her last night on A Current Affair, One Nation leader Pauline Hanson defying some of her critics to climb Uluru in protest against the decision to ban the practice of climbing the rock from October. There was also this confrontation with a group of local Indigenous women.
Do you know the word Indigenous?
Yeah, I do.
Native to the land. I was born here. Where's my land if it's not Australia?
England.
We are joined now by Pauline Hanson, along with 3AW's Neil Mitchell in Melbourne. Good morning and welcome to you both. Pauline, I want to start with you. After visiting this very beautiful sacred place and talking to Aboriginal elders, what was your impression and have you changed your mind about that ban?
No, I can see the sense in banning the climbing of the rock due to safety reasons. I did not believe how... Well, I couldn't believe how steep the climb is. There's only a chain going up it, and if you actually start to slip or fall, there's 35 people have lost their lives on that rock. So Jimpina, who actually came to see me in Canberra and invited me out there with the by the elders and the traditional owners of the land, she actually did tell me and spoke to me about the concern of the climb and the safety, plus also jobs for the locals. So that was a real issue. My going out there, I didn't have any intentions going out there to climb the rock. I was invited by the traditional owners to go out there and talk to them about their concerns.
So it was only for safety reasons then that you support the ban?
For safety reasons. I did tell them I would like to see the rock open again, but definitely some safety issues need to be put in, you know, need to be discussed and to make it a lot safer. If you start to fall on that rock, you will go over the edge. And as she said, as a ranger when she worked there, she said she'd had to phone up people from overseas, visitors and different ones, and saying, you've lost your loved one. It's very hard on them and they don't like to see that.
There's also, of course, the issue of respect. Many Indigenous people feel it's disrespectful to climb Uluru. It is deemed sacred. Neil, how did you feel seeing Pauline and, of course, many other people climbing Uluru?
I don't like it. I mean, Pauline's entitled to do it and she said she was welcomed by the local people. But we're having a bob each way. If you're worried about the safety, what about the respect? Do you want it open or not? And if you want it open and you want to make it safer, what are you going to do? You're going to carve steps into the rock. You're going to put more infrastructure on it. Don't fiddle with the rock. It is a beautiful thing, as you've established. I mean, did you talk to the Board of Management about it, Pauline? They're the ones who want to close it.
There was one fellow who was on the Board of Management. These are the people
the
who
board
are
of management
Paddy
are the people
Uluru's
who want to close it.
Brothers. He was in charge of it. I'm sorry. You don't know. You haven't been out there or spoken to the traditional
I have
owners.
Been out. The did fact you, is, did you the, talk this, to the Board of Management?
Paddy Uluru said, the sacred is not in the climbing of the rock. If you're stupid enough to climb the rock, climb it. He said, the sacred is in the land and the stories connected with the land.
Pauline,
and that's what it's about.
Pauline,
it's not about climbing
Pauline.
The rock. So understand, I'm sick of these people pushing their own agenda. Go out and talk to the traditional owners as I did. And it was Paddy Uluru's brothers that I spoke to. And right.
Okay. Did you talk to the Board of Management?
The main issue is about the safety.
Hang on a second.
The Board of Management are the people who wanted to close it. Did you discuss it with the Board of Management? No, you didn't, did you? You didn't meet the Board of Management.
I spoke to some people who are on the board. Not the whole board.
Why?
I spoke to some people
who
are on the board.
Well, the whole board made the decision to close it. Why? Why did they decide to close it? Is it Bondi Beach, as you said? It's a special place. Let's protect it and look after it. And maybe the Aboriginal people want more money to look after people in the area. If that's it, let's sit down and discuss it. But you can't just go in and debate it with a couple of waitresses from the local hotel. You've got to sit down with the Board of Management and go through what their problems are, see if it can be sorted out and respect their wishes.
You're not listening to me, Neil. The issue is the locals are not getting jobs there. They're flying Aboriginals in, as those two girls were, flying in from outside because they get paid more if they fly in Aboriginals from outside. The locals want jobs for their own. They are not getting them. That is one of the issues why the rock's not being closed.
And there's
another
a lot
thing
of
is
issues,
they
but you
don't
haven't
get
found
the royalties.
Any
They're getting very few royalties because it is... taken over and controlled by the Land Council. So they want an investigation into the Land Council. They want accountability. They want to know where the money's going, not just from their Land Council, all Land Councils, Aboriginal issues. There is such a big issue here, Neil. You have no idea. You have no idea.
Of course
you don't know what
idea.
You're talking about.
Hang on.
It's
not about me. It's about the Aboriginal people in this. Is it still Bondi Beach or not? Is it still Bondi Beach or not, really? That's what you said before you went there. It's just like Bondi Beach. It's different. Bondi Beach is exploited, developed. This is unique.
I have said I don't want to see the rock closed. We actually took, not myself, but one of my staff took Jimpner to the Sydney Harbour Bridge to look at the safety issues there and how they deal with it. So we've taken her to have a look at that. Now, we're trying to do and to communicate and talk to the Aboriginal people. There are big issues out there. It's bigger than just the rock. They're not being listened to, Neil, and there's no accountability. So,
but you haven't even met the people in charge of it.
You don't know what the hell you're talking about.
Oh,
you
yeah.
don't
well,
know what
abuse
you're
me.
About.
It's
I'm
not
sorry.
About me. It's about
Go
the
out
Aboriginal
there and
people.
Speak to them for a couple of hours.
All right. I think
you haven't met
you're
them, Pauline.
I think we're going to leave it there. Pauline, what is, I think, very heartening is you've come away with a whole new level of respect for this extraordinary...
Yeah, no understanding. No understanding what's going
sorry,
on.
Sorry, Georgie, a whole level of respect for what?
For Uluru and for the local Indigenous people was the take I got from watching you last night.
Georgie, I've always had respect for anyone who shows me respect back, and I've gone out there because I was invited. They came to Canberra to actually speak to me. They were sent to speak to me. No other senator, me of all people, because they want truth and honesty. They want me to actually listen to their concerns, and I've taken them directly to the minister because it goes bigger than just climbing the rock. Listen to what they're saying. They don't want the Uluru statement.
That's
they
true.
Hate the word Uluru used in the name for the statement. They said, shut it down, don't use our name. They can't stand this sacred of the heart in the Constitution. It's a rag. It's nothing but a piece of canvas. That's their words. So it goes bigger than this. The Aboriginal people are not really getting a true voice and being heard in this country. They've been used as pawns for people with their own agenda.
Okay, and Neil, I'm going to give you the final word.
Stunt. It was a stunt. You didn't really learn anything. I still don't know where you stand on it.
All right. We might have to pursue this again at a later date. I think
I'm a fool. Terrific. Let's abuse me and avoid the issue.
I think we'll leave it there for now. Thank you both. We appreciate
Bye-bye.
Your time.
Thanks, Pauline.
All right, tell us what you think about that. We'd love to hear from you. I feel like I'm controlling the children.
Hi, YouTubers, I'm Davina Smith. Well, click here to keep watching Great Nine videos and subscribe to our channel here for lots more news, analysis and exclusive content. For breaking news, see you at 9news.com.au.